Okay, I think we're at 6:10, right? Welcome, everybody. My name is Jonathan Barnes. I'm Department Chair of Humanities and Fine Arts at St. Petersburg College, Clearwater Campus. And I want to welcome you to the Calyx Schenecker Art Infinitum, hosted by the Crossroads Gallery of St. Petersburg College. Tonight, as we find ourselves in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic, we're having a virtual reception, but we have some wonderful guests and some outstanding artwork to look at, as well as some prizes for the award winners. I do want to remind everybody that this reception is being recorded so that we'll be able to share it later with our friends and families. And everybody, as they come into the reception to the Zoom meeting, their microphone will be muted. So feel free to use the chat feature in Zoom to give congratulations and shout outs and warm welcomes to your friends and classmates. Tonight, we're going to start off with some introductions. Again, my name is Jonathan Barnes. I'll be introducing Dr. Barbara Hubbard, who's Dean of Humanities and Fine Arts. And then followed by Dr. Barbara Hubbard will be Colonel Parker Schenecker, who will give some remarks. And then finally, Jonathan Ogle, Art Supervisor for Pinellas County Schools, will be presenting the certificates for the participants, as well as the three top, or the three honorable mentions and the three top awards. I always really enjoy this reception. I miss seeing everybody in person and giving hugs and high fives, but this is going to substitute and I hope it goes really well. Jonathan Ogle put together a fantastic slideshow of all of the participants. So the work here is really outstanding. It represents a diverse range of art and subject matter. And as one of the jurors, it's always really challenging to pick what is in this show and of course, what is what gets awards. Of course, this year I always miss seeing all the faculty from Pinellas County Schools, students, parents, families. But congratulations to everybody that was selected for this show, and a special congratulations for the honorable mentions and top prize awards. I'd like to turn it over to Dr. Barbara Hubbard, Dean of Humanities and Fine Arts, to give a welcome.
So thank you for that warm welcome, my colleague Jonathan Barnes, and welcome to this unique visual arts event and reception. We have hosted the Calyx Schenecker Art Infinitum at the SPC Crossroads Gallery since 2017. And the partnership between SPC, Colonel Parker Schenecker, and the Pinellas County Schools was formed back in 2016, and this year marks the first virtual installation. It's an enduring partnership between Pinellas County Schools, St. Pete College, that we honor the life and legacy of Calyx Schenecker. The show was founded to encourage young artists to pursue their dreams in the visual arts, and we would like to thank you, Colonel, for creating foundation scholarships for the award winners of this exhibition. SPC's Visual Arts Department has a long reputation for dedication and outstanding quality in the Pinellas County arts community, as well as statewide notoriety. I would welcome all of tonight's student artists to tour our SPC campuses and to meet our faculty in the very near future. We have programs in the visual arts, including ceramics, drawing, painting, printmaking, art history, and photography. And our two-year degree in art foundations prepares you in these areas to support transfers of your earned associate's degree in art from SPC to university art departments nationwide. So I'm looking forward to meeting all of the artists in this show and helping them to support and further their dream of a future in the visual arts. Congratulations and good luck to you all.
Dr. Hubbard, thanks very much for that great recap of things. You know, it's really funny. This is, we try to do as much good work as we can in the community, focusing on youth, focusing on character development and scholarship. I've got to admit to you, this is probably our favorite event of the year, where we get to get together to celebrate young artists. We can introduce them to the community. We can introduce the community to their work and further the arts in the greater Tampa Bay area, and specifically tonight in Pinellas County. I'm struck by the virtuality of tonight's event. there's a lot of changes this year as well, not just hosting a virtual event. There are some folks who have been instrumental in putting this program together in the past who have either retired or moved to new positions since last year. So we want to harken back, and we never want to forget anybody who are tied to our roots. So we want to thank them very much for their love and warm support of us over to SBC and in Pinellas County. As always, we want to thank the college. The college is a fantastic partner. As we're really in this, we're really just scholarship sponsors, I guess. But we really love our partnership with the college and look to making it better in the future. Specifically, you know, Jonathan Ogle, thank you very much. I want to thank you and the school district as well as being strong partners in this. The Clearwater Arts Alliance is always kind of in the wings, but they make everything happen. Thanks for the thumbs up there, Beth. Great to see you. And I wish I could be there to give you a hug. It's one of my favorite things. But we want to thank y'all as well. Y'all are great stewards of the arts in Pinellas County. We know the reputation Pinellas has, not only in Florida, but in the entire region and the nation, and how well y'all support the arts. And we're happy to be just a small part of that. We have folks from kind of around the states. I see folks from Carolina. I see folks from Buffalo. We got folks from Tallahassee. We got folks from up at Tufts. We got Army representatives. We got retired Army representatives. We got family and friends. This is a great way to gather together. For those of you who are parents of an artist or a guardian of an artist or a teacher of an artist, I just want to thank you so much for your support. I know how tough it can be to be a parent of an artist or a supporter of an artist. I have seen more crumpled up paper and more torn up canvases over my lifetime of Calyx's time as an artist than I really would want to see. But we all know that perseverance is what it's all about. And I just want to thank you and applaud you for supporting our youth, their character development, and also their art. We have a great opportunity. Kelly and I this year have a great opportunity. So this is our going on fifth, I guess, year of the Pinellas version of Art Infinitum. We're in our 20th year in Hillsborough as well. So two watershed events for us this year, and we're just so happy to be involved and on the sidelines on this. Jonathan Barnes, I left you for last because you're always the unsung hero, man. That's just kind of the way it goes to be a gallery director. But you make this so easy. You make this seamless for us. And as we come into your gallery, obviously your sound effects are awesome, though. We love them. But Jonathan, thank you so much for allowing us to virtually be in the Crossroads Gallery this year and celebrating young artists. For those of you who may not know a little bit of the background, so my daughter, Calyx, was quite a good artist. I mean, I'm a proud dad. But she was a really, really devoted artist and to her craft work. And she and her brother both tragically passed away in 2011 while I was on a deployment to Afghanistan. And as I came back and tried to lay them to rest with honor and celebrate them, one of the things that came clear to me was art was something that we needed to celebrate because of Calyx's passion. And so we jumped in with 2 feet and established Art Infinitum in both Hillsborough and Pinellas. And we're on a track right now to grow it into a couple other counties to make it a little bit more regional feel. The Calyx was a devoted artist. She was a devoted friend, classmate, and teammate. And her love for the world and her desire to capture it, whether it was photography, it was 2D, it was 3D art, it really didn't matter. She was always looking for a way to capture what was in her brain. And for those of you who knew her, her brain was pretty complex. So that was a little difficult for her to do. But that's enough said from us. We just want to thank you very much from the bottom of our hearts for your support always, your love and honor of our children. And we just want to thank you and wish all of you the best through this really strange COVID time where, you know, where things are kind of upside down right now. But kind of the one constant for us is art. Art was here before. Some beautiful work that some folks that are in on this session tonight have created in the COVID pandemic. And art will be here to pull us through the other end of this successfully. So thank you all very much for supporting the program, for loving on my kids, and for allowing us to be just a really small part of this. So I think I am turning it over to Jonathan Ogle to talk a little bit about the program and to introduce you to some of the works, the participants, and the eventual winners. So thank you very much. Much love from us from South Tampa.
Thank you very much, Colonel Schenecker. Welcome to our first ever virtual high school Pinellas County Calyx Schenecker Art Infinitum hosted by St. Petersburg College, Clearwater. I'm going to turn down my volume. There we go. Of course, we're going to have some hiccups along the way, but I'm happy that you guys are with us. I'm Jonathan Ogle, Pinellas County Schools Visual Arts Supervisor. I'm very glad that you guys could join us this evening for this very unique reception and student recognition event. This evening is going to recognize 61 of our students with accepted work into the show selected from 170 entries submitted from nearly every Pinellas County High School. We will also honor students with awards towards the end of tonight's presentation. I want to thank St. Petersburg College's Jonathan Barnes, he's the Chair of Humanities and Fine Arts, for setting all of this up, organizing our virtual reception and awards through this Zoom meeting. If you know anyone that's interested in seeing this show, but doesn't have a chance to make it tonight, all of the student artwork is posted in a virtual exhibition available in our student art gallery on our school district's website. We'll provide you with the address at the very end so you can go see that. We'll also be posting a recording of this reception event in that same spot. I want to thank Dr. Barbara Hubbard. She's the Dean of Humanities and Fine Arts at St. Petersburg College for all of her support and encouragement. Thanks to the Clearwater Arts Alliance for the top student award donations and their partnership on this special show. And thanks to the Pinellas Art Education Association, also known as PAEA, and their president, LaTanya Hicks, for donations for the Honorable Mention Awards. Additionally, I would like to thank Colonel Schenecker for creating and continuing to support this special show honoring her beloved daughter. He is truly an inspiration to everyone who is lucky enough to meet him, so thank you. Thank you, families and friends, for supporting your teenager's love of art. And finally, thank you, art teachers, for working with these students and cultivating their creative and artistic skills and producing these amazing works. Finally, I would like to share that the Pinellas referendum will be back on the ballot in November. It has passed overwhelmingly the last four times because everyone sees the positive impact that the referendum funds have on reading, technology, and arts programs across our district. Thanks to the Pinellas referendum, we're able to purchase quality art supplies for our students, provide student field trips to local art museums, and provide quality trainings for our art teachers so that they can professionally grow. And now, on to the recognition of our students with their accepted artwork and awards. What I'll be doing is reading the student's name and sharing their school. And you guys all can enjoy these wonderful art pieces, all 61 of them. So this is Maya Alahoui from Boca Ciega High School. Jaquela Harris, also from Boca Ciega. Jason Voles. Catherine Atilo Sethania Fernandez. Nijla Music. Clearwater High. Joshua Pandy, also from Clearwater High. Isaiah Sizemore, Countryside High. Maya Panito from Dixie Hollins High. Ann Ho. Riley Pitson. Rowan Van Alsberg. Fan Lin Nguyen. Christopher Gustafson from Dunedin High School. Haley Jones, Alpha Licard, Amanda Nachman, Ronnie Spann, Leah Joyce, Kristen Zavania from Eastlake High. Alexandra Cheney. Taylor Moore. Trevor Ray. Ella Dayton Yeager, Gibbs High School, PCCA. Paige Hopkins. Molly Carlson. Adria Peter. Kayla Piotti. Villette Hastings. AJ Pope. Zekayla Huggins, Lakewood High School. Gavin Reese. Anna Wetzel. Alexa Allen, Largo High School. Penelope Donetti. Lydia Eftikidis. Rachel Malouette. Rachel Singh. Savannah Dottie, Osceola Fundamental High School. Renee Favel. Ashley Ross. Emily Leandri. Isabel Ulay. Ashley Ross. Madison Cash, Palm Harbor University High. Amadio Hoxha. Alex Tsai. Valera Carrasco. Brianna Atwill, Pinellas Park High. Marcelina McCall. Evan Gordon. Seminole High School. Grace Smith. Ella Babb. St. Petersburg High School. Aiden Bashord, Tarpon Springs High School. And now we're going to go on to the student awards. The honorable mentions, again, are donated from the Pinellas Art Education Association. We want to thank them for sponsoring these honorable mentions. Vivian Dumas from St. Petersburg High. Linda Price from Lakewood High. Sophia Hicks from Lakewood High. And Kristen Zavonia from Eastlake High. And now we're going to go to our top awards. These are awards that are donated by the Clearwater Arts Alliance. I do have something to read from them. They were unable to make it this evening to our virtual event. On behalf of Roberta Clark, president of the Clearwater Arts Alliance and its board of directors, I would like to offer these following remarks. The Clearwater Arts Alliance is very pleased to continue to recognize outstanding student achievement in the visual arts through our partnership with St. Petersburg College and Pinellas County Schools in support of the Calyx Schenecker Art Infinitum. Congratulations to all of the student artists whose artwork was selected to participate in this special countywide high school exhibition. Thank you, St. Petersburg College Clearwater, for sponsoring and hosting this exhibition. And thank you to the dedicated art teachers who inspire their students daily in their classrooms and virtually. The top awards there are three of them, and each student will be receiving $100. Also, Jonathan Barnes may want to add some information about the SPC part of that giving. I believe there may be scholarships involved, so after we announce the winners, we can have Jonathan share that information. So without further ado, our top awards. Charlotte Bailey from Clearwater High, third place. Lindsay Newfarth from Countryside High School, second place. And our top award winner for first place, Michaela Townsend from Gibbs High School PCCA. Congratulations. And congratulations to all of our award winners and also all students that participated in this art show, had artwork accepted. You are all winners as well. So I'm gonna hand it back to Jonathan Barnes at this time.
Thanks, Jonathan. That was really great. I wanna let the first, second, third winners know that they're eligible for a scholarship to SPC that was put into place by Colonel Parker Schenecker a few years ago. So we'll get you that information in the next couple of weeks. And also Colonel Parker Schenecker has a special gift for the top three award winners, I believe. Is that correct? I'll unmute your mic and let you give
it. I unmuted it. So yeah, okay. Jonathan, that's true, but I'm sorry, I didn't grab one before we started, but we had a special sponsor this year, a couple of special sponsors in our scholarship program, one here in Hillsboro called Hooked on a Cure. It does a lot of great nonprofit work here in the Tampa Bay area. They were our gift sponsors this year, as well as Battle Studios from San Francisco, California, where Agilio and Delia Battle sculpt these graphite objects that are sculptures in their own right, but they're also writing instruments or art implements as well. Really one of the coolest things I've ever seen in my life. They were just lovely in their support of us and y'all this year. So the winners will be receiving those as well as their scholarships. So back to you, Jonathan.
That's great. We really appreciate that. And I'm sure the students will love those. I don't think I have anything more to say. I just want to say thank you for everybody that attended and congratulations to the winners and everybody else that was involved. Thanks so much, Pinellas County Schools, Clearwater Arts Alliance, St. Petersburg College, and Colonel Parker Schenecker. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
So proud of you all. Thank you very, very much for letting us be a part of this. Just be safe and stay connected. And we look forward to, already look forward to next year's iteration. Congratulations to everyone. And thank you very much for your love and support.
Thanks so much to everybody. It's a wonderful show. Wonderful show.
It's good seeing you, Bud.
Good night, all.
Good night, guys. Thank you.